All right, Mike, tell them what we're doing.
All right, so now we got the H bar tacked in, and now it's time to put the harness bar in. And this is kind of a crucial part. Did the little research, and the harnesses that we have actually have to like bolt or be welded to the harness bar that we have. So I came across some information that said the harnesses need to be between 0 and 10 degrees below, roughly. So it has to be mounted below your shoulders. So Mark is going to find out roughly where this bar is going to go, because it's kind of crucial, and I can't do it because I have to be sitting here. So he's got to measure me up, and that's what we're doing.
I already kind of did that. It's like his shoulder's right here, so it comes about to right here. And then about here to here, I wouldn't say that's 10. That's probably like 20 degrees. But if we had it 10, it'd be probably around here, and the harness would be like, it wouldn't line up with the holes in the seat for the harness to go through. So I have it about right here. So when it's bolted to the harness bar, it's going to be going straight through these harness holes. Like you can see right there. So that little mark right there is where the top of the harness bar is going to be mounted.
Let's put it in.
All right.
Okay, so we got this notched up. We think we got it level, but might not be level, I don't know. We're working on it, but
hold that right there.
We're about to tack it up. Oh God. Mark, I'm scared.
I got the top part of this torsion bar welded up. If you want to know what a torsion bar does, just watch the roll cage episode. I think it's like 2 or something. So this is the first piece I got all trimmed and notched, so I'll get it tacked in. So is that the only bar that's going to be there?
Yeah, there's one.
Yeah, you die! Let me drive! Drive! Let me drive! Alright, we're tackling the last piece, and then we can weld this whole thing together.
What are these?
They're tabs for the harness mounts or harnesses. Yeah, through these holes.
Okay.
Alright, so you're wondering like what's this little bolt here doing? And it's a camera mount. So threads in the bottom of Mike's camera. And we get some pretty cool shots with this thing. It'd be a little bit tricky welding this.
I have faith. Man, Mark did a pretty good job welding this cage up. I'm glad we got these harnesses in too, I freaking love it. And I tell you what, I have a major woody pecker. woodpecker. So if you guys paid attention on any of the early videos of the Sentra, I have Gumby hanging from my rearview mirror. I like to have like one of my favorite kid cartoons like in the car with me as like a guardian angel, but like a guardian cartoon. And this rope, what kind of cage wouldn't be complete without a bird? Because it's a bird cage after all. So we gotta put the bird in the bird cage. It only makes sense, right? Right. All right, so we installed the Woody. We just used some zip ties, like bondage style. Tied his hands and then his feet, and then tied his hands and feet to the bar. He's pretty secure. He's gonna be having a lot of fun. He's gonna be watching over us. Should be pretty cool to see him go side to side in the rearview mirror. And he might even be the cameraman for when the camera's right there. So it'll be pretty cool. All right, welcome back. We finished up the roll cage, and now we're still doing some weight reduction. This guy right here. It's the ABS module. If you guys watched the hydraulic handbrake video and paid attention, you would know that we bypassed it with the rear brake, and we don't even have the ABS computer hooked up. So we're not even using this, and this is weight and taking up space, and we're gonna take it off. What we're gonna do, we're just gonna take these three front brake lines off. We don't need to worry about the rear because it's not being used, and then we have to put a T on it. Now, we couldn't buy from our local stores a metric T to fit these. We can only get a standard, so what we have to do, we have to cut these fittings off and then flare on standard fittings for the standard T. So it's gonna be fun. So let's get to it. So we gotta take off all four of these brake lines. This is the rear, so we're just taking it off and leaving it, but we gotta put this one, and this one in a T, and then we're done with the brake lines and we bleed it, and then there's like four fasteners holding this on. I think we have to jack up the car and take the wheel well out, and then we will take this out and it'll be saving some weight. And if you have a freshly painted engine bay or want to protect your paint, you might want to put rags down or keep on a can of brake parts cleaner handy, because brake fluid eats paint and you don't want it dripping all over your paint and heating it off. But we don't really care. This engine bay is already kind of screwed anyway, so we're just gonna, whatever happens, just let it happen.
Seems to be the motto around here.
You know, I said that to a girl on my prom night.
Did you?
Yeah.
And
she wasn't even my date. We were just laying in bed. Everyone else like left to go do something, and I was just laying in bed with her. And I was like, you know, whatever happens, just let it happen.
So what happened?
I fell asleep. So she let it happen.
What a perfect ending to a perfect night. I just want to sleep.
Story of my life. All right, so here are the three brake lines that we have to put in this T here. All we have to do is cut each end off, flare it, and put some new unions on, and it's done. All right, the T's in, all the fittings are on. Can't really see if there's any leaks right now, but after we bleed it and take it out and drift, hopefully it doesn't leak and we lose brake pressure and crash, burn, and die. So, we jacked the car up and took the wheel off, and now the wheel well's out, and now we can get to the fasteners holding an ABS module. We got one there, and then one there. And you do this.
from Dennis.
Boom. We're on the last fastener. I think once all these bolts are out, it's just a couple electrical connectors we got to undo, and then it should come out. All right, so we undid this connector here. Moved this connector out of the way. I think it's ready to come out. There's probably gonna be some brake fluid that's gonna come out with it. Oh, gotta undo this one. Yeah, that way. We're good. It's actually pretty heavy.
Now we have so much more room for activities.
All right, we're all done the ABS delete. We teed the lines, removed the module, bled the brakes. Now, the fun part comes by taking that out. You know what that is that I'm pointing to? The twin turbos. We've got a single going on. And that's gonna be awesome! But, we're gonna be having a giveaway. Lucas from Lab Japan actually sent us a whole bunch of Lab Japan and Japanese goodies. So we're gonna be having a giveaway. And here's how you win. This is part 3 and part 4 of Drift Missile. We're gonna be removing that and putting in a big single turbo. And then we're gonna get a final weight of the car and see how much weight we gained or lost. Whoever can post in the comments below before part 4 comes out, whoever can guess the closest to the exact weight in pounds will win. And you also have to be a subscriber to both of our channels. So subscribe to both of our channels, then guess your best guess for how much this car will weigh in pounds. And the closest person will win. And we'll see you next time on part 4.